Yeah, let's try this deck right now. Forsake the Worldly. I guess it goes Rest in Peace. I kind of just have like a little bit of everything in my sideboard. And it doesn't really make a whole lot of sense. But I don't want to bother with sideboard too much right now. Shredded Sails. I think I'll just... Oh, Gravity Gear Schedule also doesn't make sense with Fadeless Looting. It's good against Company decks, though. And maybe I'll just add the, like, high-impact cards. I'll add Baffling End. I'll add Hushbringer. I don't actually think you want to play Talia. Okay, let's keep it like this for now and try it out. Historic Cycling. Let's go. I would like to play first. That's a turn two. Oh my god, you love to see it. You do love to see it. Can we get another holo one, please? So this is a turn one flame blade adept. Turn two, play Fadeless, or Cycle Creator, play Fadeless Looting. I guess this deck doesn't really have Bloodghast. Is there something in Historic that just like comes from the graveyard? Are there any Bloodghast or anything like that? Come on, holo one. One time, let's go. Close enough. Solid turn two, I guess. I'll take it. There has to be something, right? There's always something in like every format that just keeps coming back from the graveyard. Marvel, okay. I could play one Fox and then cycle, but I think I might just like cycle. Maybe one Fox is okay. Cycle, attack for seven. If I draw another land, I attack for eight. I think one Fox is okay. Cycle Stinger. Ooh, there's the holo one. I guess I'll play this then. Let's see if we can do 13 damage. Well, I guess 16. I do need to be able to do more. So now I can play land, crack this, put holo one into play. But that's pretty bad against Extinction Event. And I guess I can do the same by just cycling twice and then just playing the land and playing the holo. Oh, I don't even need to play the land, actually. Never mind. Well, okay, we're doing that. So what's the worst that can happen? They play Marvel, they play like, I guess Ulamog, Exile to two lands would be pretty good. I'll just play out everything if they need to. If they need to sweep the board or something, I'll just Zenith Flare them. All right, easy. Nothing free as Bloodghast. That's unfortunate. I guess I am going to bring in the cage because it is really good against Marvel. It kind of just stops that deck. And I guess Talia is also pretty good. I just board out some random cyclers. How many lands do I actually have in this deck? 14, so I have 20 lands. That's pretty good, I guess. I guess Casto is better than guess these are the worst. I don't know if I need the otherworldly thing or the worldly or worthy or whatever that is. Because if they play Marvel, they're very often or almost always going to be able to just activate it right away. And we'll keep this hand. I think I'll play Adept instead of Fox, because this might be a game where I don't even get to cycle a bunch, so I might just need this to cycle it rather than the other way around. I will play Thalia now, though. That should slow my opponent down considerably. Fruitful Craves. I can go cycle, then see what happens. That's pretty good, I guess. Cycle. Attack for 6, play Hollow One. No big deal or anything. So what I should do, I should just be trying to find Flame. Zenith Flare? Yeah, I mean, they're kind of dead. Yeah, Fateless Fitting is a nice upgrade for this deck. That does look kind of nice. It's like super smooth. Maybe you don't need to play that many Cycling Lands. Maybe having like 4 of them would be okay. Though I guess the Cycling Lands are just like better than some of the spells, because the spells are kind of bad. Yeah, I think there should just be more lands. That doesn't make sense. Like Go for Blood, like Fruitful Crater. I don't think you're going to be doing that very often. Or like playing Drained Healer. Yeah, there should just be 4 Cycling Lands of each, because that's just better than the spells. And the sideboard needs to be better. But yeah, let's not bother with the sideboard for now. It's a Zenith Flare hand. Opponent mulligans. Drain 3, maybe Hollow One. I think it's better to just mulligan and just try to find a one drop. Like having Fox or Adept would just be so much better. But maybe these hands are okay in Historic. There's a lot of decks in Historic that just cannot beat a Zenith Flare. Like if I'm playing against Monored, like I would be happy to keep this and just do a bunch of cycling. Then just put Hollow One into play on turn 3. I'll try to keep this for science. I don't think it's a great hand to keep, especially on the draw. Like you don't really have any pressure, so like this loses a lot of value. Like this card is great when you know you have 7 or 8 cyclers in your graveyard when you deal 10 damage with your creatures. But if this is supposed to do all the work, then you have to cycle 20, which is a lot more. Just a lot more than like 8 or something. I'll actually cycle Cave because it cycles for red, and then I can keep this for some other color of mana. This one's good. Sensor, okay. You got me. Like, now if I had Forgotten Cave in my hand, and I draw planes, I basically cannot cycle red, red, white, or like red, red something, because I wouldn't have double red. So I think this turned out a lot better, and now we just need to find a cycler. Easy game. Thanks for playing. Yeah, no wonder Javier plays his deck in every historic format, in every historic tournament now. Like, it really plays pretty smoothly. Memory lapse? Sure. Oh, yeah, I'll just do it next turn again. I don't mind. That has to be like one of the worst cards to have to memory lapse. A braid? Well, I guess that's okay. I don't think I have anything in my deck that would prevent this from happening, but I'll try. This is the weirdest thing about playing a lot of colored cyclers. This is why I like the Boros more aggro list with Lurus a lot more before, because the more cards like cast out, or cast down, cast out, and like all of these cycling lines you play, the harder it is to sometimes like what color of mana am I supposed to keep? Like, I can just draw into something that it's going to be a lot harder to cycle. Like, now it's still going to work out because I have a dual end, but sometimes it can be pretty awkward. Also, like with mulligans, right? Like, what kind of hand are you going to keep? Sometimes you just have to keep one red, one white, and then you just have too many like white cyclers or red cyclers. They have another braid, or what's going on? All right, nice. Now the question is, do I play Fox or do I just double cycle and go for Zenith? Flares. I think the fact that like both of them just kill my opponent now together, I think it's fine to play Fox. And I should actually cycle right now, because maybe I want to put the untapped land into play. Also, I can draw into a one drop, that also works. Oh, wow. What? That's pretty good. That is pretty good. I'll let Autotapper decide which color of mana we're going to keep. I could just play that. I think it's better to play that. I think our opponent's going to be on some kind of like combo deck. I think they might be playing the Locust God plus the 2/5 combo. That's why you would want to like put treasures into play early. And how do you get them both in play? There has to be a way to... How does that deck win? The sort of Splinter Twin deck? I don't remember exactly. How do they get both creatures in play? They don't just cast them for 6 and 5, right? Like, that's just so much mana. But maybe they do. Thalia is nice. I don't think I want Cage. I mean, the Locust God is an enchantment, I think. Enchantment God or something? The Locust God VG. Is it, or is it? No, I'm thinking of something else. It's not an enchantment. So I guess this does nothing.
I guess it's better than Creator.
Four damage to a flying creature or something, some kind of artifact. No. I mean, without knowing what they have in their deck. And you're right. Creativity. That's how they get into play. I was like, there's no way they cast that, right? That just wouldn't make sense. This is a really, really nice hand. Looks like everybody's in love with the new sideboard UI. Doesn't really matter what I play turn one, I guess. So I have more red cards now. I'll play the land first. So I don't get four spiked again. Okay. Make a treasure token, sure. Draw two, make two treasure tokens. Oh, wow, what? Okay. That's a pretty busted card if you can cast it, I guess. All right, give me some 4/4s. How about that? Should probably cycle first, actually. And I could cycle one more time and then try to get holo ones. Because if I cycle, it's gonna give me like more options. But I guess I can also just find a creature that I could play. So maybe this is better. I think I'll discard one land. I don't think I need another one. Okay, let's do this. And hello one. Hello, one time. All right, close enough. I guess we're playing this one. Cast out can get rid of token. So basically on turn three, my opponent used two cards to kill my board, draw two cards, make a 4/4. Yeah, that's pretty good, I guess. That does... Wait, they didn't attack? What the hell? What is happening? Then I guess I don't need to cast out. I'll just pass. I don't know what's happening. Maybe they can just like combo off in their turn or something. I guess I'll just pass and be ready with the cast out. And if not, I can just cycle a bunch of cards. What? Oh my god, that's... What? Okay, not bad. Not bad at all. So I guess I kind of do need to go for Zenith Flares. Wow, look at that. That is a nice combo. Well, here's hoping. Okay, too late. What are the chances they don't have sensor? I wanted to play this in the upkeep, but I guess it didn't work out. Okay. That was really cool what my opponent did. I don't know if it's like tier one kind of cool, but this with Gearhulk is pretty reasonable. I kind of like that. That was really cool. Against Gearhulk, against this. That doesn't work, right? Exile target card. For each card exiled, copy it. Yeah, that's not how... That doesn't stop that, unfortunately. I don't think I want Cage. I'm on the play, I'm gonna be very aggro.
Need a way to re-spark the excitement in your TCG collection? Box breaks are the way to get your hands on cards from the games you love. Learn more today at cfbboxbreaks.com or check out CFB Box Breaks on YouTube.
All right, we have a one drop. We keep. Wonder if it's ever right to just play this as a 2-mana 2/2. I guess I should have attacked first if in case they have Magma Spray or something, because now they just Magma Spray the Flourishing Fox if they have that. Okay, sensor. Let me remind you that the box breaks on channelfireball.com are going to have the collector boosters from Strixhaven that have the Japanese mythical archive cards or mystical archive cards, which is definitely pretty cool because they do look kind of nice. So if you're into that stuff, if you want to get a part of the box, you can go check it out. In the meantime, they should have tapped Red Source. Well, I guess it worked out for my advantage now. Okay, that's what I was looking for. Actually, is it? I could play Adept. Maybe it's better to just keep it as a cycler. Yeah, it might be better to just keep it as a cycler, actually. Ooh, okay, now I definitely want to keep it as a cycler. So let's go. Let's cycle this one. Cycle this one. Red or white? I think I'm doing red. All right, go to five. The problem is that my board's gonna die, and then like I'm gonna have a Zenith Flare, but I assume my opponent's never gonna tap out. So we're gonna be playing a game where like I have a lethal card in my hand, they can never tap two mana because they have a Disdainful Stroke. If they ever do, I guess I'll respond to that. So it's gonna be interesting. I think I can't afford to do this. Now I don't know if I should be playing the Stinger. Maybe just cycling is better. I could just dice like a command. Yeah, I think right now I do want to play the game. Like I never play anything, you never play anything. And like I tried to draw into another Zenith Flare, and then at some point I'll play one at the end of turn and then another one. Okay, I guess we'll just do it now. Yeah, they're in a position where maybe they just can't really afford to keep up the open mana, because then they will just never play anything, and that also just doesn't really work very well for them. So maybe just they just have to go for it and hope that I don't have anything. All right, I'll play one more. Thalia actually looks pretty reasonable in the sideboard. I thought it would be bad because of the cards like Fateless Looting, but there are a lot of decks where it really is very good. Like, there's going to be a lot of Brainstorm decks. There's going to be a lot of like new combo decks, like Arclight Phoenix. Like, you just play Thalia. Like, good luck playing three spells in a turn if you don't have a shock. Yeah, I think having Thalia in the sideboard actually makes sense. Even though you are playing Looting and Cast Out and these things yourself. Oh wait, we're playing the mirror? I should have discarded this guy, not the oof. Oui, that was not good. Do we go for Fadeless Looting, or I guess we say Fadeless Looting in case we draw a Hollow One. Like as soon as I draw Hollow One, then I want to fire off the Fadeless Looting. It's kind of like a two card combo that's like both of the cards are good on their own. Oh, they kept the Forgotten Cave, Secluded Step draw. Yeah, you don't love those. You do not love those. So definitely want to get rid of Looting and I guess a Stinger. This is free, not too bad. Attack for five. Solid start. My Zenith Flare is already on five. All right. They're keeping two mana up. Cycle. This is a three. They probably want to double block this. I could just kill the fox and attack for five. And keep the two flares in my hand. Yeah, I kind of like that. Just press the advantage if you can. If I attack with both, I think they just double block. Yeah, they just double block the holo one, and then I can only kill one of them. So yeah, I think this was better. Yeah, my opponent's pretty dead. If you have to do this on turn four instead of like interacting with the opponent, then that's not very good for you. I think Baffling End is probably good in the mirror. It does seem to be a lot about the one drops, but at the same time, like maybe Hollow One is also where it's at. Maybe these are like answers for Hollow One. I don't know if this is right. Maybe I'll have like three. Healer. What's the worst one? Creator and Healer. Don't know if this is right. I guess also Sweltering Suns could be good, but on the draw, sometimes you don't even get Fox with it. But maybe, I should have brought in Sweltering Suns. Like, I'm on the draw, like, I'm going to be getting attacked. Like, sometimes they're not going to have, like, the perfect opener. Not with double Forgotten Cave. Better. Not great, but better. I can just do Holo One on turn two. Ooh, actually the perfect one drop. Probably even better than Fox in this situation, because it attacks for three and doesn't get blocked. And we still need to find a cycler, but come on. Okay. Now what do I get rid of? I get rid of a land and a land? I can't discard Zenith Flare, can I? I also kind of want to play the Fox. I don't want to cycle it. Oof. What am I supposed to do? I like all of these cards. I'm gonna be very greedy here. Very greedy. Cause I have like one draw step plus, or one draw from the cycling plus my draw step. And I would basically need to draw two Zenith Flares to not be able to continue either cycling or playing lands. And like, this is so good in the mirror that I also don't want to really discard one. Although right now it only deals one damage. So maybe I should have discarded it. But I guess if I'm not drawing lands, I'm drawing cyclers. And if I'm cycling, then that's good enough. Now I don't know what to do. I guess I cycle Hollow One, play the cave, but then this is only dealing three. Yeah, if I kept the line over this, then I would be able to just cycle Forgotten Cave, play a land, play Hollow One. That would be better. Maybe I just need to get lucky. Screw it. Let's go for the high risk, high reward play. Oh, it costs three. Oh, okay, never mind. Then that doesn't work. All right, then cycle it, we will. Okay. Hmm. I can play Looting and discard the Adept and then just play Zenith Flare. But I think it's better to just try to deal damage with creatures. So I think what I'm going to do is just play this. Cycle. Try to make a land drop. Okay. Oh, what up, Nassif? Hello, everybody. Welcome. Thanks for the raid, Gabe. We are playing some Historic, trying to abuse Fateless Looting in every possible deck. Not every possible deck. I played some Rakdos Arcanist before. No, this is pretty awkward. I played the blue-green taking turns deck that Luis played tonight. That was also pretty good. Now we're trying Cycling. I don't know if it's the most busted deck in the format now with all the new cards, but I think Looting does make it better because it's so good with Holo One. What did you guys play? I haven't played Phoenix yet, no. It is on my list of things to do, though. Am I dying to Flare? I probably am. I'll just discard this. I just need to find a land. How long until we... I think if there is ever the original art, they will probably just make it cost like 20,000 gold or, you know, 10,000 gems or something for the OGs. You want to have, you know, the nice art? Just pay a bunch of money for it. Oh, you played the 100th. That tournament's already over? I thought about playing it too, but then I realized that I would have to start at midnight and it was double elimination with a million people, so... Oh, okay. That explains everything. Pass, I guess. 8, so... I'm barely surviving. I guess I should probably respond. If they already have the Zenith Flare, I'm dead anyway. Because they just kill me. 2, 4, 6, 8. Yeah, I think I should respond. Maybe there's some world where I don't die. 9. Actually, I die anyway, because this is 13. If they have the flare, I die anyway, so it doesn't matter. Okay, I get it. That I shouldn't have done it because there is a world where I need to kill the Adept if they just go cycler. But I'm pretty sure I'm dead because they got priority at the end of my turn, and they could have just played the Zenith Flare. And instead they just untapped and Maybe I'm wrong. But I guess if I'm forced to kill the Adept here, then I'm very unlikely to kill my opponent anyway. Yep, I'm dead. That was not the best way to play that one. How many Baffling Ends do we want on the play, and do we want the Sweltering Suns? Would have been pretty good here. It's like, it's good in your bad draws, and it's bad in your good draws. Like, same thing with this. I don't know if I even want this on the play. Maybe not. Maybe I just want the Cyclers just to, like, have as good a draw as possible for myself. And this is probably bad, too. Yeah, on the play, I'll just try to do my thing without slowing my deck down or anything. First, I guess we keep that. Yeah. I'll shock myself. I think I'm playing this on turn two, this game. They have a fox. I am so dead. Yeah, I'm super dead. Maybe there's some world where I just play double stinger and then I just cycle a bunch and jump block once or twice and just somehow win. This match is so weird. Or this matchup, rather. I will not block. Holo one, okay, that's nice. How do we do that? I could play Stinger and try to play Holo one next turn. I could also kill the Flameblade Adept. Oh my god, I have so many options. Let's say I play Stinger, then they cycle. Let's say they cycle twice and have to play a Teflon and just something normal. Take four, I think seven. And then just very likely die the turn after. Okay, I don't like to do this. But I think I have to do it. Oh, wrong card. I don't think Baffling End would have saved me either. I guess I would have been able to deal with this, but... It's probably the fact that you just can't beat the fox draw with like two twos. Yep, I'm at 11. They already have a four in the graveyard for cyclers. So if I play Stinger and I start cycling, then I just die to Zenith Flare. Not next turn, but the turn after. Is there some world where this just kills them? Play this cycle, draw line cycle, take four, take six, or 12. Next turn, I don't have enough. So it's probably better to just play Holo One. I could play Fox and Holo One. No, I can't. All right, let's try this then. All right, Holo One, let's go. One more Holo One. One time. Oof, close enough. Could we have killed the fox? And no. This is why I didn't want to bring in the Baffling End, because it doesn't do anything with the Holo One. If they have Cyclers and Zenith Flare, I can't win, but I also can't win if I chump block here. This just doesn't seem like a great play. So they have the Flare, I'll just accept my loss. Trading the Stinger for the Fox, that's really bad. Okay. What are my options? Looting, no. Play both creatures, jump. I mean, yeah, I guess I can't really do anything else. Faithless Looting is also kind of strange in this deck. Like, it's good in the good draws with Hollow One, but if you don't draw Hollow One, it's just card disadvantage. So that doesn't seem that great either. All they need to do is just... Yeah. Oh, no, they need to cycle and then cast Flare. Okay. I think I'm now stuck in a chump block mode. I'm basically under the abyss, and I don't think there is a way out of there. I don't even have like five lands so that I could looting into Zenith Flare. But maybe I can just top deck Zenith Flare. 1, 2, 3, 4. Actually, no, let's just count the ones that don't cycle. I have one non-cycler. So if I just block and I draw Zenith Flare, I think that's 12. Oh no, that didn't work. All right, I don't know what the way to break the mirror is. Like, you could bring the Baffling Ends, but then my experience is that every time I did that, my opponent just like got two Hollow Ones into play, and I had a card that like I literally couldn't use the entire game. But then just like not boarding it just seems like you're just leaving it completely up to chance. Like, nobody has any cards that interact, and it's just about whoever has the better draw. So that doesn't seem that great either. Not really sure what's the mirror breaker. And like the same thing goes for the something, Sweltering Suns, because like it can be great sometimes when your opponent has, you know, two Adepts or like Adept and the Stinger, but this game it still wouldn't have done anything, because if they have a 6/6 Fox, does nothing, cycle for three is extremely expensive, that plays really badly with Hollow One. So not really sure what the best mirror breaker is. Like, something that like kills a creature but also an artifact, but it needs to cost like one or two mana. I don't think there's anything like that. Gabby, I was just gonna raid you. I think this was probably my last match. I'm super tired. It's 4 a.m. But thanks for the raid. Welcome, everybody. We were just trying some historic stuff. I played the blue-green historic deck that Luis played on his stream. That was very fun. I think that deck has like very strong potential, but needs to be a little bit tuned. I played Red Black Arcanist. I thought that deck was very good, but also needs to be a little bit tuned. And then I played this Boros deck with Faithless Looting, that just trying to get, you know, Hollow Ones into play fast. That was also pretty good. It's the classic day one, everything feels good because people are still trying stuff out and not everybody's deck is, you know, super polished or whatever. But yeah, that was this deck. I'll try something else afterwards, but probably tomorrow. How did you guys? How did you guys do? You probably drafted, right? You're going offline? Yeah, I streamed for like 5 hours, I think. I do want to go back to streaming, so I'll be streaming more. I do need to do some things this weekend. Plus, I'll be playing the Strixhaven pre-release that you can all sign up for if you go to strixhavenparty.com, and you can check it out, how to play, how to set it up, how to use spell table, how to sign up for the event, how to use the official Discord channel, or Discord server rather. And I'm playing the Blue-Red Guild Prismari. If you wanna join, go head over to that website, and I should be playing on Sunday, but I'll probably like showing up at the Discord or maybe hanging out and watching some games over the weekend. Rip apart. But does it kill like a big fox? I do remember. Three. It could be playable for sure. How's your cat? He's here somewhere. I think he's sleeping though. I do need to go find him. All right, Gabby. Yeah, see you later. Thanks for the raid again. I will probably pass it to somebody else. Who do you guys think we should raid? Benes, MJ, Seth is streaming, Corey is streaming. I'll probably just raid Corey. Corey, I like Corey a lot. Raid Corey B. He's also definitely playing some. Oh no, he's Corey B MTG. Corey B MTG. He's also definitely playing some Bruce and he's a fun person to watch. Have fun morning. Yeah. I will. I still need to finish writing an article and then I can finally go to sleep. So it's gonna take a little bit longer, but yeah, have a good night, guys. Thanks for hanging out with me. Thanks for the raid from Gabby. Historic's fun. Magic is fun. Everything's great. See you guys. See you guys next time.